Carol does it sometimes.
Yeah, it does. Thank y'all. Thank y'all for coming.
When I was a kid, I'd take a trip every summer out of Mississippi. This is my granny and her antebellum world. I'd run barefooted all day long, climbing trees. There is a song. One day I happened to catch myself a squirrel. Well, I stepped it down in those shoebox. I punched a couple of holes in the top. When Sunday came, I stuck it in the church. Way back in the bird last view, showing him my dear buddy Hugh. That squirrel got me, so went totally berserk. What happened next is hard to tell. Some thought it was heaven, others thought it was hell. Back to something that was lost was plain soon. As the final thing I surrendered all, the squirrel ran out of farm humans overall. Farm leaped to his feet and said, "Something got a hold on me." It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah!" The barn started to hit the aisle, thanks to them screaming. Some thought he had a ridge, and others thought he had a big barn. Thought he had a weed in his
house.
He fell to his knees to beg and plead, and the squirrel ran out of his stretchy legs unobserved to the other side of the room. All the way down to the Amen pew, where Seth's sister Bertha Bethany knew, who'd been watching all the commotion with sadistic glee. But you should have seen the look in her eyes when the squirrel jumped her arms and crossed her thighs. She jumped to her feet and said, "Lord, have mercy on me!" As the squirrel made laps inside her dress, she began to cry and then to repent for sins and make a slipper, thus for shame. She told of gossip and church dissension, but the thing that got the most attention is when she started talking about her love life, and then she started naming names. That day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church, and that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah!" Seven deacons and the pastor got saved, and $25,000 got raised, and 50 volunteers and missions in the Congo on the spot. And even without an invitation, there were at least 500 rededications, and they all got rebaptized whether we needed it or not. Now, you've heard the Bible story, I guess, how he parted the waters from Moses to rise. Oh, the miracles God has wrought in this old world. But what I remember till my dying day is how he put that church back on the narrow way with a hag craze, Mississippi squirrel. The day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church, that sticky little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival, and from down in revival, they were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah!" The day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church, that's the little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah!" Yeah.
Yeah.
You gonna let me? I'm gonna do another one. That other one, Jerry. Yeah. An hour. No, we'll go ahead and do it now.
You gonna save your battery?
Yeah.
Y'all heard this one, like, hey, this is Mr. Fogart. I'm changing the pace on things. Y'all, J.W. and Joe Nevis heard these couple songs about, what, happened a million times now?
No. They
can
get better
with each one. No, they don't. I'm just going to think of anything else to put down.
Numbers.
Numbers. Yeah, numbers. Yeah. Numbers. Yeah. I'm not. Hey, that's tomorrow. That might be for tomorrow. You going to Backwoods tomorrow night?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll be there. And the street too. That's another one.
Yeah.
I like the face. I like them face with you.
I
can. Yeah.
You can't get all the words. I can't get all the words, and you get them.
I don't, if you notice, I don't, somehow I don't get them all in either. Just going so fast you don't realize.
I hope it don't.
Well, if you're one of the millions who live on one of them gas cranking, piston clanking, air polluting, smoke belching, four wheel buggies from Detroit City, then pay attention. I'm about to sing your song, son. Well, now, I'm not a man to point to judge, to bear real will, or hold a grudge. Time to think of a few choice words. All about that demon automobile, the metal monster with the polygrass wheels, the end results of a dream on every floor. Well, now I've got a car that's mine alone, that me in the vine that's cut me on, a ready-made pile of manufactured grief. And I ain't out of gas in the pouring rain, I'm a change in a flat, a hurricane, I once spent 3 days, 3 days walking on a clover leaf. Well, it ain't just a smoke in the traffic jam that makes me the bitter fool I am, but this poor real buggy is dollaring me to death. With gas and oil and fluid grease and wires and tires and antifreeze and metal accessories, well, honey, that's something else. Well, you can get stereo tape and a color TV and get a backseat bar and reclining seats and just pay once a month like you do your rent. Well, I figured it up over a period of time. This $4,000 car of mine cost $14,000.99. Well, Lord, Mr. Ford, I just wish that you could see what your simple horseless carriage has become. Well, it seems your contribution to man, to say the least, got a little out of hand. Well, Lord, Mr. Ford, what have you done? Oh, Jerry, play that guitar again.
Yeah.
Now, the average American father and mother own one whole car and a half another. I bet that half car's a trick to drive, don't you? But the thing that amazes me, I guess, is the way we measure a man's success by the kind of an automobile he can afford to buy. But I'm red light, green light, traffic cop. Right turn, don't turn, must turn, stop. Get out the credit card, honey. We're out of gas. Well, now all the cars placed end to end would reach to the moon and back again, and that'd probably be some poor fool pull out of passion. Well, now how I yearn for the good old days without that carbon dioxide haze hanging over the roar of the interstate. Well, if the Lord had made the moon and the stars would have meant for me and you to have cars in the same and all born in the parking space. Lord, Mr. Ford, I just wish that you could see what your simple horseless carriage has become. Well, it seems your contribution to man, to say the least, got a little out of hand. Well, Lord, Mr. Ford, what have you done? Come away with me, Lucille, in my smoking, choking automobile.
Hey y'all.
Are we next? Joey?
Yes, I think.
What am I saying? What did you put me down for that?
Check. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4.
That was a lot.
He's going to do two and then y'all.
This is like, most like a gospel song. Born in the heat of the desert, my mother died giving me life. Deprived the love of a father, thank for the loss of his wife. You know, Lord, I've been in prison for something that I've never done. It's been one hill after another. I climbed it all on my own. Oh, but this time, Lord, you gave me a mountain high, a mountain I may never climb.
It's on a hill any longer. So tired of working for nothing. Just tired of being my wife. She took my one ray of sunshine. She took my pride and my joy. She took my reason for living. She took my small baby boy.
Jimmy Dillon.
All right, we got one more, Elvis.